hear it from you. Desert snow.
Turns like this, I mean, it's kind of sketchy. Maybe if you feel good enough, go to at least the other track, you know,
yeah.
The right track, so that you're at least halfway on your side.
Yeah,
cool. Yeah, this isn't so bad. It's really rocky, at least.
Yeah, that little turn there was a little slippery on the high side, obviously.
At the top there, I was just going diagonal. I'll say, though, this is promising. Our voyage out seems to have shown that we can actually make it to Crown King, asterisk. Subject to warmer climate.
Yeah. Yeah,
warmer temperatures. Yeah. Yeah, I got nice engine braking on mine. Got a wonderful kind of sparkle to it. It's like golden. Oh, I know you're nervous. Thing is, it could just take a turn like it does right there and just goes down the hill and destroys the trail. Oh, yeah. Yep, that's just flowing down the hill. You're doing good. I can see why you can go up these. I mean, it's like tank tread. Wow. Those ridge lines are just so beautiful. Covered in snow. Love these winter trips. Thanks for wanting to do it.
Yeah.
You know, I was kind of like, I don't know. But what good is sitting home watching TV? Watching other people's riding videos when I should be riding myself. We all do it. Wow. That is an amazing drop.
Yeah. Okay, am I going like embarrassingly slow or anything?
Not at all. No, I think slow is the right speed. It's the cheapest speed. Yeah, look at this tree right here on your right. It's been uprooted, the little guy. Or cut or something. It looks like they might be doing work on this. Keeping it. Yeah, probably to make it bigger. Yeah, is it just my goggles or is that water sparkling like 24 karat?
Oh, yeah, it's sparkling.
I think your exhaust just hit me. It was like, yep, you're doing great. But seriously, those are some monster tread.
Yeah, they're nice.
Yeah. I look at mine, because I can see mine next year's as you're going down, and yours go twice as deep, if not further.
Yeah.
Mine really slide bad now.
Really?
Yeah. I am becoming less than satisfied with their minuscule nugget height.
Yeah. I think my camera just shut off, by the way.
Well then. Look at those white waters. On the road.
I know.
There's a butterfly literally flying with my ATV. This is ridiculous. And it was white. I think it was from Ice Fantasy.
Wow.
Yep, she winks me. Watch it, folks. Really? Really? Just the first couple episodes of Ice Fantasy did it? It's a good time to discuss it, I feel, due to the nature of the environment.
I mean, hold on for an extra episode.
Okay. It's rich, I'll say. It's very sweet. Yeah, it started that way. But it's gone a little soap opera. And it's no Ashes of Love. So it's not that far along, you know? But...
I'm not going there.
But... Is this the right topic of conversation? Moving on. So this is, like, it's holding up a little better down here, but still flowing.
Yeah, it's flowing good. I definitely want to see different things about.
That's a sweet bike.
That is a sweet bike.
Spring Flower.
This might be enough to make the scenes.
Not me.
At home watching the video.
Not me, man. I'm sucking it in.
There's little flowers right there. They're cute little ones.
Yeah, they are.
Oh,
Botanical Garden.
Oh, wow.
prospecting.
Oh, we got some doggies up here. Oh, there it is. Oh, and a baby one. All right, well, here we are. That's pretty normal. So here we are, the official Micah Brothers Mine. And water. Yeah. Oh, wow, look at that. That's so cool. Oh, and there goes the tarantula hawk wasp. All right, let's see where parking is. So what was this, an old stamp mill? Wow, there's still a belt even. Look at that thing. I think that's the way in right there maybe, or maybe there's another entrance over here. Okay, this is the easy way in, which in itself is kind of rough looking. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to do that hill climb. Just kidding. What do you think right here? Or do you want to park them in the shade?
Tour in the mine, or I should say the mill. This is known as the Micah Brothers Mine. Don't know the date on this, but it's old.
Well, here I am riding in the desert, and what do I find? My husband, honestly.
I just use lots of steam to get through. Alright, so we'll keep going. Yeah, that is definitely the connector bit.
Wow.
or if it was paved. Or if it was paved. We do have kinky tires, so the truck would just be kind of balloony sitting on them, you know? Probably as close as we're
going to
get.
All right, going to pull down the quadricule here. Kind of let it go here. Ooh, it's piping hot down there. All right, now, just to pull those parts out. It's a tight fit, but it comes out relatively easy. The clips off. This thing's hot without gloves. Burns. All right, there's their sausages.
Those are good.
Here are the Oscar Mayer smoked sausage, and here's the Huffy smoked sausage. And this right here, ooh, that's so hot. These are mixed veggies. Mm. Looks like they kind of settled. Some settling may occur during transport. Mm. All righty, well.
Not a bad lunch.
No.
How
about you? No. All right. Here we have the Trailside Quad-BQ Feastery, and now the long-anticipated smoked sausage shootout.
Mm-hmm.
First, I'll go with the Oscar Mayer myself. It's kind of wrinkly, nice and greasy.
Yeah. And then you said the next one is this also an Oscar Mayer?
Also an Oscar Mayer.
And two Huffies, all right. I'll go for my bite of...
All right, just got a flake of rust right there.
Mini bike reveal.
Here it is, after the long wait, the fully upgraded mini bike. Got some 20-inch knobbies on it to replace the 18-inch tires that were on it. Front rack is installed. LED headlights. The torque converter. Basically swapped out the single speed jack shaft for a fully automatic transmission. Pardon my shadow. And here we have the back rack with its adapter plate I had to fab. And here we have regulator rectifier that I got to run the LED lights. I'll say right now, I've already taken it out and it's a hoss.
So flush. And for the record, there is 20 pumps of slime from the gallon jug in each tire, because yep, we're out here. We're in good old desert. So yeah, and the rack looks great. How does it feel to you?
It feels pretty good.
You better grip and rip it, man. Yeah, it definitely has a, and in the sand, it's kind of a little wishy-washy.
A little, but I'm playing overall, so it's awesome.
Yeah. The play school, my first gas can, is like glued to the bike. Yeah. Yeah, this is going to be interesting. All right. So you're getting the hang of it pretty good. The sand is the most nerve-wracking. Yeah. It's like that in the sand. My advice is to throttle out in those situations. It doesn't really help the actual user, but yeah. All right. These are just always a little challenge. That's it. That's it. Yeah. Kicked out a big rock, right? Oh, you're fine. You're fine. It's just, you know, it is what it is. That stuff's hard to ride through. Yeah, so if you're ever like going into those situations and it feels wishy-washy, just nail it. Just kidding. Yeah, the what you're riding on is just melting under you. You're getting the feel for it though. It's definitely like, you're going straight onto the trail too. I had the nice road warm up. So this is kind of nice feeling though, I bet. Yeah, started you on the double black diamond. Figured that's the best way to get you up to speed quickly. Yeah, it is a unique challenge riding the mini bike, but it's even more of a unique challenge in sand. Yeah, that's when I try to get away from you. Back off a bunch. I'll say overall, I can tell that tire is definitely soaking up the bumps. Yeah, those knobbies are pretty much designed for this. Yeah, I guess you're gonna figure out doing hill climbs after you go through that. Yep, you got it. Just watch out for magic trench. So yeah, it feels great. Like, it's never been able to cruise before. It always just feel like, oh, it's at its top end and it's barely moving. That's right to the base.
Christmas ride.
We got rain coming tonight. I might be discouraging them. That's why we're pushing for today's trip instead of tomorrow. Because this is a mess when it's wet. Yes. In what way? Well, I'm glad I wasn't behind you for that one. Yeah, you're chucking mud like crazy. I'll say you should avoid them too, because you'll cover me and the bike. Not the vehicle for it. I'm gonna stay on your left side. You're still pitching crazy mud. It's like been non-stop since that puddle back there. I know, and you think with the worn tread it wouldn't get that much. Oh, yeah, that just hit me. Yeah, you think with the worn tread it wouldn't be that mud grabby, but you know, being black diamonds, they have a natural propensity to grab and throw mud in an aggressive way. At all the water. Yeah, it is. Right on. Hopefully this is not flooded. Nope, it looks like we're good. Ooh, this smoothed out. I love the monsoon renovations. Yeah, smell a little bit of cow. Ooh, that smells good though. Kind of lemony. That just helps you around the turn. Actually, that takes us to that road too, doesn't it? Let's take the northern top part. Yeah, I don't think it's too big a hill. Can't believe it just drove off that. Yeah. Oh, I found a tire. Last ride. Happy New Year, folks, and you know, really appreciate y'all staying tuned. We've been trying to make the videos better, and I hope they're coming out better for y'all. But yeah, Merry Christmas and Happy 2020.
Bonus camp ride. Thank you.
folks. Well, we're back at the claim. Rock-Dolla's got the mini bike at camp, dropping off some stuff he's already backed up. Let's go ahead and walk up this creek, see what we're looking at here. We have metal detected this in the past, but as you can see, there's a lot of overburden and a lot of this is new. So I came up yesterday, didn't find any lunkers. There's a lot of promising things here. One of these things is I like that gravel layer on the rock. That's kind of nice. Someone's been digging that, so I might sample that too. And let's see, I got a shovel. Just brought back the solar panel to charge up the little vax. Oh, what do we got here? This is Rock-Dolla's workings. Oh, I see what he means. We're hoping that's a nugget trap right there. We get a better view. This comes down that way from all the gear. Spills this way. That's a pretty crazy hole to have right at that rock, so hopefully it pays out. I'm gonna pan it here in a little while. Let's see what we got. And I think I just heard the mini bike stop, so Rock-Dolla's back. And we're gonna get to work. Alright. Alright, everybody, we're back and we're getting ready for lunch. And we started to pan out the stuff that we've been digging up on that hillside that Rock-Dolla showed you. And we got a good chunky piece earlier. Rock-Dolla just started panning again, and with the camera adjust, and boy, oh boy, what have we there? Not only are there multiple pieces, folks, but that is the biggest piece we ever got right there. And we don't even know how big it is yet. So we're gonna probably stop recording, and we're gonna pull him out.
I got nugget shakes officially, people.
I think we're gonna start dancing. Point to it. Like, I just want like a nice good, yeah, it's big.
Nugget. Big. Nugget. Woo.